My Line. Brought to you by Geritol, the high-potency vitamin iron-rich tonic in liquid or tablets to help you feel stronger. And now, let's all play What's My Line? And now, from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, one of the devastating stars from the hit review Beyond the Fringe, also the impresario of a big nightclub in town called The Establishment, Mr. Peter Cook.
It is my pleasure to introduce Tony Award winner, Phyllis Newman.
And on my left, the publisher from Random House, my friend, Bennett Cerf.
And here's that exemplary panel moderator, news analyst, and vocabulary builder, John Charles Bailey.
Well, that was nice of Bennett. Actually, he does a great deal more to build vocabularies than I do, because his dictionary is one of the really fine publications of Random House, Bennett, and I mean that quite seriously. I must say, Peter Cook, it's nice to see you, and certainly, Miss Newman, nice to see you back on our panel again.
Thank you. Nice to be back.
I trust you both enjoy yourselves in the next half hour. I know I'm going to. We've got some very interesting occupations. We will also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. And we'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now to meet our first challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Keun Oh Kin, is that right?
Oh.
I suppose I'd better confess that I knew you were going to do that and that I can't really read Korean, huh? Think I'd better confess that?
Yeah.
It's very nice. I must say, I wish I could write that well in English. So you must do very well in English and in Korean, too. You can tell us where you're from.
I'm from Seoul, Korea.
From Seoul. Nice to have you with us. Miss Kim, is it Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Miss Kim, may I present our panel, please? And now, would you join me over here, please? Miss Kim, coming from Korea, do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes, I do.
All right, fine. In that event, we will let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Miss Kim is salaried and deals in a service. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Miss Kim, do you work for a non-profit making organization?
Yes.
Or would you say that it is a governmental job of any kind?
Yes.
Yes. Do you represent your own country in some capacity?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Cook.
Do you deal in your service with children?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Newman.
Miss O'Kim, do you work in the United States?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Miss Kim, do you have anything to do with either travel, transportation, or taking care of tourists in any way?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Well, do you hold your job in your own country of Korea?
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with law and order in your country?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Cook.
Are you in any way connected with medicine?
No.
Six down and four to go, Miss Newman.
Are you an elected official?
Were you elected in your
country? No.
No.
7 down and 3 to go, Mr. Sir.
You did establish, Miss Kim, that you are in a non-profit. You were in a non-profit line. Is that right? The service is non-profit.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Does it in any way involve writing or television or radio?
Yes.
Oh.
Would it possibly be something to do with television or radio?
Yes.
Do you appear in either television or radio in Korea?
Yes.
Do you possibly... Well, now must we decide what Miss Kim does on...
Well, no, actually, Bennett, I think I'm going to put all the cards over, but I think we must agree that you have fundamentally identified Miss Kim's line. Just for fun, see if you can figure...
Does she do... I would say she would probably be a wonderful person for doing news broadcasts or doing What's My Line.
Well, you're absolutely right. Miss Kim appears on What's My Line television in Korea, and it's a government non-profit operation because the government operates the television. It's one television station.
Sure, glad they don't do that here.
Yeah. The television station's in Seoul.
Yes. Uh-huh.
How long has the show been going in Korea? How long has it been on?
Since 1957.
Heaven's sake.
Yes.
Now, Miss Kim has another distinction. Actually, Miss Kim is a captain in the reserve in the Korean Air Force and was trained in the Korean War and flew as a liaison pilot during the war. One, I believe, of a few. How many of Korean women were trained to be pilots?
15 girls.
15 altogether.
Really?
Miss Kim is still in the reserve. So, Captain, it's nice to have had you with us. I always salute superior rank. Nice to see you. Now to meet a second challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? A.G. Summers, right, sir? All right, Mr. Summers, where are you from?
Daytona Beach, Florida.
You know, taking a look at that tan of yours, I might have guessed that you were a Floridian. It's nice to see you. May I present our panel? And now would you join me over here, Mr. Summers? Do you know how we keep score?
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Summers is self-employed and deals in a service. And let's begin the general questioning with Miss Newman.
Thank you. Mr. Summers, in your service, do you have to do with people?
Yes, sir.
With the people of both sexes?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you come to them, go to them for your service?
No, ma'am.
1 down and 9 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Summers, in the service that you perform, do you sometimes come in contact with tourists, visitors to the Daytona Beach?
Sometimes.
But it's not exclusive, you're not exclusively devoted to taking care of tourists?
No, sir.
I would go beyond that, Bennett. I think to be completely fair, Mr. Summers would, in the normal pursuit of his line, have some contact with tourists, but it would not necessarily have particular reference to his line.
Mr. Summers, do you do anything in the line of police or detection work?
No, sir.
2 down and 8 to go, Miss Francis.
Mr. Summers, do you use your hands in your job?
Yes, ma'am.
Would you say that it requires a certain kind of dexterity with your hands?
No, I wouldn't think so. No, I think you'd have to give you a no on that. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Cook.
Do you work outside, Mr. Summers?
Yes, sir.
You work exclusively outside?
Yes, sir.
Do you work... when I'm availing myself of your service, I am with you outside, in fact.
Yes, sir.
And do I physically benefit from this service?
Definitely so.
Definitely so.
Well, let me say here, and I trust Mr. Summers will agree with me, we would have to say that perhaps some physical benefit would be derived from the healthy outdoor activity, but not necessarily would it the basic end of what
I was
going
to say. It's very hard to improve me physically, outside or inside. No, not exactly that. I'm just saying people have tried and failed is what I meant. Would this activity take place on the water?
No, sir.
4 down and 6 to go. Phyllis Newman.
Mr. Summers, if I came to you for your service and were outside now, would I have on something that's different from what I'm wearing now?
No, ma'am.
I wouldn't?
Well,
I mean, would I wear a dress?
Yeah, I think here perhaps we're getting into another area. I think what we mean to imply here is that you would not directly avail yourself of Mr. Summers' service.
We'll
have to give you, we'll give you a shot at another question. I think perhaps one of our answers might have confused you.
I would be outside with you, but I wouldn't avail myself of your service. Is that right? Would I send somebody else to you?
You could.
Would you touch me in any way?
We know.
Even if I asked?
Mr. Summers, look, not on my way. That's 5 down and 5. 5 down and 5 to go, Mr. Sir.
Now, Mr. Summers, you testified that you did not work in the water, but there is a very famous beach at Daytona Beach. Does your work ever take you down to the area of the beach?
No, sir.
6 down and 4 to go, Miss Francis.
Mr. Summers, since Miss Newman would not avail herself of your services.
I wouldn't be caught dead there.
and you wouldn't touch her with a 10-foot pole, which seems pretty silly to me. Would it be mostly men who would come to you for your services?
Yes, ma'am.
Are they men that work out of doors, too?
Well, I would say that their coming to Mr. Summers would indicate that they would like very much in their employment to work outdoors.
That's
yes.
Right.
Did Mr. Summers say earlier that people would be benefited by his service?
Well, we agreed that there might be a certain amount of physical benefit just out of the good, healthy outdoor life,
I
but
see.
It would not necessarily be pointed to that direction alone.
May I rule out that Mr. Summers has anything to do with the entertainment world?
Yeah, we do.
Well, I would... just a moment, we're going to have a
find out how entertaining it is.
Oh,
I may go.
You want to rule out that Mr. Summers has anything to do with the entertainment world.
That doesn't mean sports. That's just entertaining.
La-di-da-di-da-da.
That's what I said, John, before you turned the card. Wasn't that clever of me?
Well, since you said it before I turned the card, you go ahead.
You have to give me another go at it, don't you?
Baseball.
Do you have something to do with sports?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, Mr. Cerf feels that it's baseball. Do you have something to do with baseball?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Cerf is right. I passed to Mr. Cerf. No, I don't pass to Mr. Cerf because there are two in between.
Don't pass to me, if you're going to say. That's what I'm worried about.
Would you be considered not a player, but rather an umpire?
That's right.
He's an umpire.
You're an umpire?
That's right.
One of the best, too.
Well, Mr. Cerf knows what team you're an umpire for.
What do you mean, umpire for this team?
Right away, it's a crooked game!
We will agree, Arlene.
I mean, what league?
We will agree that Al Summers is an umpire, but we're here tonight to determine what his line is. Now, what is his line?
Umpiring.
Well, he does some umpire. Yeah, he's an umpire.
Is he also a manager?
No, that's 7 down and 3 to go. Mr. Cook.
He's an umpire, and he's a player as well.
That's very good. That's 8 down and 2 to go.
No,
you're an umpire, and you have something to do with eyeglasses.
With eyeglasses. 9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, what do you want to know? I think he's the most important umpire, and he's the head of the umpires of... One of the veteran umpires in the baseball.
Al Summers is a great umpire, but what is his line? What is the other line that we're seeking?
Besides being an umpire?
Yeah.
That's right.
He,
Is it also connected with baseball?
Mm-hmm.
He's a doctor.
It's one you'd get in a minute if we weren't pushing you so hard. He runs a school for umpires at Daytona Beach. And and places many of them in the big leagues. But you've been an umpire for over 20 years.
Oh, 22 years.
22 years. Oh, that's wonderful. You were the Pacific Coast League.
That's right.
Well, how's the school? How's the school teaching business?
Very good. We're right next to the Daytona Speedway. We got 70 students representing 23 states, Canada, and Cuba.
Isn't that great? Oh, that's wonderful.
I think, Mr. Summers, that the umpires are the most mistreated, underpaid people in professional sports.
I agree with you.
Well, that takes care of that. Now, anybody else want to make a complaint here, Mr. Summers?
I was going to say, don't go to England, because as soon as you appear on television there, they'll say, what's the difference between baseball and cricket? I've had it 8 times over here. So.
Well, actually, if you understand bats, I guess that's it, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah, that's fine. Al, thank you very much for being our guest. Lovely to have you with us.
You too.
We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our sponsor. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel, as you well know, are always blindfolded. Are those blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good. Will you enter Mystery Challenger and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Bennett Cerf.
Are you a representative of the entertainment industry?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Are you represented in the theater?
Yes.
Mr. Cook?
Have you also appeared in films?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
Do you get the girl? I mean, you're not a girl, are you? Do you get the girl in your movies? Are you a leading man?
No, the answer is no. That's one down and 9 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Would you be therefore described as a character actor more than a leading man?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Are you a dramatic actor rather than a comedian?
Yes.
Mr. Cook?
Have you ever been in a really huge, spectacular film? Enormous Ben-Hur type?
Yes.
Yes.
Miss Newman?
Have you ever appeared in a musical?
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Sir.
Were you in either Mutiny on the Bounty or Lawrence of Arabia?
No.
3 down and 7 to go, Miss Francis.
You're answering in a very niggardly way. Are you by any chance from the same country that Peter Cook is from?
Yes.
What?
Yes. Mr. Cook?
Are you regularly stationed in London, then?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
I think I know who it is. Are you Sir Ralph Richardson?
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, yes.
I do think we must say that Ralph Richardson gives one of the most brilliant performances of his career in a picture called Long Day's Journey into Night.
Yes, he does.
I think the picture. Richardson was up and away before I could note any of these things, but it is. It's one of the great pictures of the year, and certainly his contribution is magnificent. Well, I must also say, panel, that you seem to have done very well so far tonight, and we'll have another challenger, another contestant, after this word from our alternate sponsor. And now to meet another contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Patrick Troy, right? That's
Troy, where are you from?
I'm from County Offaly, Ireland.
County Offaly, Ireland?
Ireland, yes, sir.
Ah, it's nice to have you in the United States now.
Yes, sir, I am.
Oh, good. Well, may I present our panel? Troy, will you join us over here? Do you know how we keep score and what's my line?
Yes, sir.
Fine, then we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right, panel, we can tell you that Mr. Troy is salaried and deals in a service. And let's begin the general questioning with Peter Cook.
Mr. Troy, would I come to you for my service? For your service, rather?
Well, yes.
Yes, to receive the service, you would have to take the initiative to go into the general vicinity where Mr. Troy was.
Are you working over here at the moment?
Yes, I am.
You are? And you'll be here permanently?
Oh, yes.
I see. When I come to you for your service, do I go away... obviously, I go away happier if I've had the service, but do I in any way physically benefit from the service given to me?
No.
No, I wouldn't think so, Peter. One down and nine to go, Miss Newman.
Are you headquartered in a large building of some kind?
What do you mean?
I mean, if I came to you for the service, would I come to a large building?
Well, what do you mean by large, Phyllis?
Oh, larger than two stories.
Yes.
I would. Would I come to you and would I talk to you?
Yes.
I would. Would I ask you advice about something?
No.
No. Two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Troy, do you perform your service for a profit-making organization?
Yes.
It is. Does the organization for whom you perform the service deal in some kind of a commodity that can be consumed?
No.
3 down and 7 to go, Miss Benson.
You work for an organization. Is that correct? You're not self-employed.
No, he's salaried
and works for some other person. Is
does quite a lot of money change hands in the place that you work?
No.
4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Cook.
And there are only a few people working with you in this building, which is larger than two stories, and to which I would come. There are, you work with a group of people, a small group of people.
Yes.
And do you chat amongst yourselves? Is it a non-stop service? Do people come to you continually through the day?
Pretty much depends on what day it is. You know, these things up and down, up and down. It could be, Peter, that it could be a continuous risk. But on the other hand, you could have a quiet day, you know?
Once I'd been and had the service, would I need to come back?
Pretty much depends on what happened when you came the first time.
Do people generally come back? I mean, I'm no doubt they'd want to, but do they say, well, see you next week, see you next Tuesday, when you can do the service again?
Well, it would all depend, I...
It would depend, pretty much. I think we have to give you a no on that, because it's not mandatory. 5 down and 5 to go, Miss Newman.
Mr. Troy, did you have any special training?
Yes.
Did you go to a specific college or school to learn what you do?
No.
But you had specific training?
Yes.
You're finished.
That's 6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Cerf.
I get the message.
Mr. Troy, have you some other title other than Mr.? Are you referred to by some title rather than Mr. Troy, such as Dr. Troy?
No.
7 down and 3 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you wear anything other than the business suit that you have on when you're doing your job?
Yes.
Would it be recognizable if I saw you in this costume or uniform?
Yes.
Yes.
Arlene, I'm sorry, but I'm going
I'll
to
you.
Did you have an idea? Because
No. I thought maybe you were an usher or something like
that. Well, actually, Mr. Troy is a butler.
Oh!
And he's presently a butler in Georgetown, Washington, D.C., but came over from England, where you were, I believe.
No, Ireland.
From Ireland. Whoa, what a mistake I made. I'm sorry. But it was wonderful to have you here with us, and thanks a lot for being our guest. Now, I'm afraid I've used up all the time, and with the panel's permission, I will say goodnight for all of us, and thank you for being with us on What My Life. Thank you. CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. Johnny Olsen.